Our fourth episode, Chapter 4, is about managing the controller switch, as well as introducing something new in VIQC Next Level, the match stop time. DexIQ challenge teams will have two robot drivers at field side for any one match. The drivers use the controller to control the robot. The controller gets handed off anywhere between 35 seconds and 25 seconds remaining in the match, so both drivers get a chance to drive. Although teams practice this and there are warning sounds at both the 35 and 25 second marks in the scoring software, it's also a great idea to remind teams of this. We recommend saying something gentle at the 35 second mark, such as saying, "You may now switch." This will remind students of the timeline without making things too urgent or frantic. Then if it gets closer to 25 seconds, give them a second, stronger reminder. We want refs to be helpful and lenient while aiding in the process to ensure all controller switches take place within the appropriate time window. If your event has an announcer, he or she may be better suited to handle the switch driver's call. This is something that can be worked out at your local event. In the end, we just want to promote fair play and a positive experience for teams throughout this process. Please note that the specific situation of a team with only one driver at an event is addressed in Rule G6 of the VIQC Next Level Game Manual. Teams with only one student in attendance at an event are granted an allowance to use a qualified driver from the event. No student may fulfill the role of driver for more than one team at any given event. One other note worth considering is programming skills matches. As mentioned above, the driver switch does still apply in driving skills matches. However, since there is no driver in programming skills matches, there is no controller switch necessary. In fact, per Rule PSC2, only one driver is required for a programming skills match at all, though teams may still have two if desired. Next is the concept of match stop time. This is something new for VIQC Next Level, so let's take a look at the definition. Match stop time is the time remaining in a tiebreaker finals match when an alliance ends the match early by placing their controllers on the ground. The match stop time is rounded down to the nearest even number. For example, if controllers are set down when the displayed time is 13 seconds, the match stop time is recorded as 12 seconds. If an alliance does not finish the match early, they receive a default match stop time of 0 seconds. So, this only applies in the situation where there is a tie for first place and the two top playoff alliances are playing their one tiebreaker match. In this tiebreaker match, alliances now have the opportunity to prove their skill not just in points, but in how quickly they can accomplish it. The score that they post is still the primary tiebreaker in this match, but if the two alliances tie again, then it goes to match stop time. Referees will need to be diligent in paying attention to the clock in a tiebreaker match, and teams will need to be efficient in scoring and placing their controllers down to indicate that they're complete. Because this could be the first time that the teams have ever encountered match stop time, referees should take a moment before the match begins to make sure that everyone understands, including the teams, the announcers, and the audience. That's all for Chapter 4, but make sure you check out our other videos in this series.